This illustration is about no sliding between bodies. Based on such illustrations, you'll see many cases in future. Here the figure shows three bodies of equal masses m each. And the friction coefficient between body surfaces is mu and ground here is smooth. We are required to find the minimum and maximum force F to be applied on block 3 for which blocks 1 and 2 does not slide over 3. So, in this situation here we can write as the three blocks will move together as 1 and 2 are not sliding on 3. We can write as all bodies move together. The acceleration of system can be written as F by 3m as we are given that ground is smooth. Now, if we draw the free body diagrams of 1 and 2 for the minimum value of force when the bodies 1 and 2 has sliding tendency in such a way that 2 will have a tendency to move down and 1 has a tendency to move toward right. So, in this situation, here we can see if we draw the free body diagram of block 1, it will be experiencing its weight mg in downward direction, a normal reaction N1 is in upward direction, toward right is the tension. And as it has a tendency to move toward right, backward limiting friction on it in the limiting case when F is minimum, or we can write it mu N1 and it will be mu mg because the value of N1 is mg. And this will be sliding toward right with acceleration A. Similarly, here if we draw free body diagram of block 2, you can see its weight is in downward direction, a normal reaction, N2 would be acting toward right due to block 3, and a tension is acting in upward direction. As it has a sliding tendency in downward direction, in upward direction it will experience the friction, and under limiting condition it will be mu N2. And it is going toward right also with acceleration A. So, if we write equation of motion for blocks 1 and 2, here you can see, for block 1 we can write the equation as T minus mu mg is equals to ma, that is here first equation. For block 2 moving toward right, it can be written as N2 is equals to ma, that is our second equation. And in vertical direction, block 2 is not a sliding. So, here we can write mg is equals to T plus mu N2, that can be written as mu ma, that is say our equation 3. Now, if we simplify these equations, here you can see, if we add equations 1 and 3, you can see 1 plus 3 will result. Here T gets cancelled out and we are getting it as mg multiplied by 1 minus mu is equals to, this will be ma multiplied by 1 plus mu. Here m gets cancelled out and the value of acceleration we are getting is g multiplied by 1 minus mu upon 1 plus mu. So this is the minimum acceleration which is required to keep body 1 and 2 moving with a common acceleration a, or at rest with respect to block 3. So, we can write the value of minimum force here, which can be applied to keep block 1 and 2 to be at rest, would be 3m multiplied by a, that can be written as 3mg multiplied by 1 minus mu upon 1 plus mu. This is one result of the problem. Now, as force increases, we can see acceleration increases, and with increase in acceleration with respect to block 3, 1 and 2 will have a tendency to move in opposite direction. So, at maximum value of force, 1 has a leftward sliding tendency and 2 will have upward sliding tendency. So, here we can redraw the free body diagrams of 1 and 2. So, we can write at F max, FBD of block 1, if we just have a look, it would be like this. It is experiencing mg in downward direction, N1 is in upward direction, tension is toward right, and as it will have a leftward sliding tendency with respect to block 3, So friction will act on it in rightward direction, which will be plus mu mg we can write. Still it is moving towards right with the solution A. Similarly, if we draw the free body diagram of 2, here we can see compared to this FBD, the difference here is in the direction of friction. Mg is downward, T is upward. Normal reaction N2 is still toward right. The only difference is the direction of mu N2 will get changed, as with respect to block 3, 2 will have upward sliding tendency, and still it is moving toward right with the solution A. Now, if we write the equations of motion for block 1 and 2, here you can see the equation would be for block 1, we can write T plus mu mg is equals to ma. And for block 2 here, we can write, this is again N2, we can write as ma. Along with this, we can write for its vertical motion, which is at rest with respect to 3. So here we can write T is equals to mg plus mu n2, which is mu ma. Say if these are equations 4, 5 and 6. Here again from equation 4 and 6, we can eliminate T and get the value of acceleration. So here I can write for solving the equation 4 minus 6, you can see what we'll be getting here. The value of T gets cancelled out, and what this will give us is mu mg is equals to ma minus mg minus mu ma. And here if you simplify this, here m gets cancelled out, and the value of acceleration we are getting is g multiplied by 1 plus mu upon 1 minus mu. So if this is the acceleration, it will give you the value of maximum force, because minimum we already calculated. So the value of maximum force we can calculate here again by using the same relation as common acceleration is F by 3m. So it will be 3ma, and the value of acceleration is g 1 plus mu divided by 1 minus mu. That will be the maximum value of force which can be applied on the block 3, so that 1 and 2 will be kept at rest with respect to block 3. So if the applied force is between F min and F max, here we can see blocks 1 and 2 will be at rest with respect to block 3. The only difference will be on varying the value of F, the magnitude and directions of friction acting on 1 and 2 will change, but these will be considered, these will be at rest with respect to block 3 during motion.